5,000 years ago, the world was overburdened by demoniac kings who terrorized all of its inhabitants. Foremost amongst these demons was the Bhoja prince, Kamsa. His intent was to consolidate alliances with all the other demoniac kings in order to launch a powerful attack upon the devotees of Vishnu. In his quest for strong alliances, Kamsa was happy to marry his sister Devaki to Prince Vasudev of the Yadu dynasty. To their marital home. The procession of horses, elephants, musicians, and servants were passing very pleasingly when suddenly a voice boomed from the sky. Kamsa, you are such a fool! You are driving the chariot of your sister and brother-in-law, but you do not know that the eighth child of this sister will kill you. Kamsa caught hold of Devaki's hair in order to kill her. Vasudev, shocked at Kamsa's behavior, attempted to calm his brother-in-law. The greatest warrior of your time. How is it that you are prepared to kill your own sister on the occasion of her wedding? Why do you fear death? Death was born along with your birth and is an inevitable fact of life, whether it comes now or later. Please, you need have no fear of your sister. The danger is to come from her children, who aren't even born yet. If there are any sons born of her, I promise that I shall present all of them to you for necessary action. Kamsa was satisfied by this promise, and they continued on their way. In due course of time, Devaki gave birth to a son. With great pain, Vasudev took the newborn child to Kamsa, but was surprised when Kamsa graciously let him take the boy back home. Soon, however, Kamsa ordered his guards to imprison Vasudev and Devaki. He even arrested his own father, Ugrasena, seizing the kingdom for himself. Within the prison, shackled in iron chains. Vasudev and Devaki gave birth to 6 sons, one each year. And Kamsa, thinking that each of the babies was possibly an incarnation of Vishnu, killed them, one after the other. Shesha was transferred by Yoga Maya to the womb of Rohini, Vasudev's wife, who was living under the care of Nanda in Gokula. Shortly after this apparent miscarriage, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Lord Sri Krishna, entered into the heart of Vasudev to become his 8th child. As the setting sun's rays are transferred to the full moon rising in the east, so the Supreme Lord transferred himself from the heart of Vasudev to the heart of Devaki. In this way, Devaki became the residence of the Absolute Truth. But because she was in the prison house of Kamsa, she looked just like a suppressed fire, or like misused education. Kamsa, however, noticed the beauty of his sister Devaki, and fearfully concluded that the Supreme Personality of Godhead had taken shelter in her womb. He patiently waited for the deliverance of the child, expecting to kill him as he had done previously. In the midst of his anxiety, the image of Vishnu began to haunt his every waking and sleeping moment. He was so absorbed in thought of the Supreme Lord that he only saw Krishna, or Vishnu, around him. Brahma, Lord Shiva, Narada, and all the other demigods invisibly appeared in the house of Kamsa to offer prayers to the Personality of Godhead within Devaki's womb. When the time came for the Lord's appearance, signs of good fortune were everywhere. The rivers were flowing full of water. Lakes were filled with lotus flowers. Within the forest, birds were singing, peacocks danced, a pleasant breeze blew, and the clouds in the sky mildly thundered and showered. The Brahmins, who had been forbidden from offering sacrifices, felt peace in the core of their hearts and joyfully rekindled their fires. The denizens of heaven showered flowers, the Gandharvas sang, and the Apsaras danced. We'll be right back. Thus, when everything was perfectly adjusted, the Supreme Personality of Godhead appeared in the dense darkness of Kamsa's prison, just as the full moon rises in the sky. His four hands held a conch shell, disc, club, and lotus flower, dazzling with the complexion of a bright blackish cloud. He wore a helmet bedecked with the Vaidurya stone, from under which flowed an abundance of curly black hair. His Kaustubha necklace flashed upon his chest, and his belt sparkled upon his silken yellow dhoti. His effulgence brightly lit the dark prison hall. Vasudev could understand that Lord Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, had appeared as his son. All fear of Kamsa vanished, and with great joy, he mentally gave thousands of cows in charity to the Brahmins. Overcome with wonder, both he and Devaki offered beautiful prayers to their son. Devaki, however, could not resist her motherly instincts. She entreated her son, "My dear lord, Kamsa may have already heard of your birth. He will soon come to kill you. Please hide this form so my brother will not be able to find you." The Supreme Lord responded with great affection, "My dear parents, you have raised me many times as your child with great affection and love, and I am therefore obliged to you. I understand that you are very concerned for me and afraid of Kamsa. Therefore, I order you to take me immediately to Gokula and exchange me with the daughter who has just been born to Yashoda." Having spoken thus, the Lord turned himself into an ordinary child and remained silent. Being thus ordered by the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Vasudev took his son from the arms of Devaki. By the influence influence of Yoga Maya, the shackles slipped from his wrists, and all the prison doors opened, though they had been barred with iron chains. As Vasudev cautiously stepped out of his cell, he found that all the guards were fast asleep. The night was very dark, but Vasudev could see everything as if it were broad daylight. As he stepped out of the prison, he was met by roaring thunder and torrential rain. But Anantashesha spread his hood over Vasudev to protect him from the downpour. When Vasudev came to the bank of the Jamuna, he saw that the water was roaring with waves and full of foam. As he waded in, waters quickly converged around him, swelling until a terror-struck Vasudev thought he would surely lose the child in those raging waves. But Jamuna Devi's only intention was to grasp Krishna's lotus feet. Upon touching his feet, her waters parted, making way for Vasudev to cross. Upon arriving in Gokula, Vasudev noted that all the inhabitants were fast asleep. He quickly entered Nanda's house and, as ordered by Krishna, exchanged his son for their baby girl. Then he made his way back to Kamsa's prison. He silently placed the girl on the lap of Devaki and clamped on his shackles. The crying of the newborn girl awakened the guards, who quickly informed Kamsa that Devaki's eighth child was born. Eager to eliminate the cause of his fear, Kamsa rushed toward the prison cell. Ignoring the pleas of his sister that he should at least spare her daughter, Kamsa forcibly snatched the child from her arms. But the girl slipped up out of his hands, appearing in the sky as the goddess Durga with eight arms. Angrily she addressed Kamsa, "You rascal, how can you kill me? The child who will kill you has already been born elsewhere. Don't be so cruel to your poor sister." With great shame, Kamsa released his sister and brother-in-law from prison. But his fear only increased because now he knew that his killer was out there somewhere. But where? In Gokula, Yashoda had forgotten whether she had given birth to a boy or a girl due to the influence of Yoga Maya. She awoke the next morning to find an exquisitely beautiful baby boy lying by her side.
Swagatam Krishna, Suswagatam Krishna.